Lydia Cota Birenbaum, and I am a member of CDL, Citizens Defending Libraries, and I have been a member of this group basically since the inception of the group. And I'm here to oppose the sale of the Brooklyn Heights Library. We are here in that charrette, which is a charade, really. A lot of the information that we need to make an informed decision has not been provided for us. We know very well that it's not about the library really per se, it's about the huge building that they want to build.
Right.
On top, the high rise, the luxury high rise that they want. And then the library is going to be cut down to a third the size that it is right now. And they are basically lying to people, representing that the same amount of books or more that we have here at the library presently is going to be in the new library, by the way, one third the size that it is right now. That doesn't make any sense at all. You cannot fit a round peg into a square. It just doesn't fit right. You want to say something?
So the people, what's happening now in this room, there were tables of groups of people that are basically designing the new library.
Exactly.
As if it's like a done deal.
It is not a done deal. People, it is really like a game, and a weird kind of game, because we're looking at pretty pictures, and then you put a red dot if you don't like the configuration or the furniture or the space, and a green one if you like it. But it means absolutely nothing, because they're not giving us the numbers, how big the space is going to be, the building that's going to go on top of this library. It's just, I know what this is about, though. It's about letting the community know, putting it out there, that there was community input, when in fact, there's no community input, because I've collected almost 20,000, our groups, Citizens Defending Libraries, over 20,000 signatures, and people don't want their library torn down. They want it refurbished. This is a game that's been played from the Bloomberg administration, underfunding libraries, so later they can get the developers in here, to the developers, real estate developers, so they take over the land, public assets, then they ram the libraries into basement, shrink the libraries down, mm-hmm. and then they have their big high rise,
right.
Which, by the way, is going to be impacting this community if they get to build this huge 33-floor high rise condominium dramatically. The trees are not going to get enough sun. There's going to be shade. People are going to lose their views. It's environmentally horrible, not to mention the destruction of the library. All they need to do here at the Brooklyn Heights Library is refurbish it. Refurbish the library, put the money people that we need to talk to is de Blasio, Mayor de Blasio. He promised us, he stood in City Hall when he was running for mayor, and he told us that he was completely opposed to the sale of the library. But now he's not come out and say, you know what, let's stop this, let's fund the libraries properly. In fact, he underfunded the libraries, and it's shocking to us. But we are going to get to de Blasio, and we're going to tell him, we're going to remind him of the promise that he made us. He's not going to play us for fools. These developers have been taking over public assets, and this is just the Brooklyn Heights Public Library. It's just one piece of land that they want to get their dirty little hands on, and then shrink the library, leave the people with a tiny little space, the seniors.
They want to move the business part of this library
to the central library.
The Grand Army Plaza
Library. This business library is so important to this community and surrounding community members come and use this library. So it's not only for the Brooklyn Heights people. This library serves so many people, including tourists. This is a very well-known library. Is downtown Brooklyn.
So you are
Carolyn McIntyre
and
Marilyn Burkhan.
So you are completely opposed to this idea of
stealing public assets like public libraries and then giving them to private wealthy billionaires who are going to build stash pads. Yes, we're opposed to that.
And the course of this meeting, though, was focused on picking.
Thank you for coming, Catherine.
Thank you. Picking patterns of colors and.
It meant nothing, of course, because it was a game. We were designing a dollhouse.
Right.
A third the size of what we have now. How could it possibly be anywhere near as good as what we have now. And when I spoke to the architect at the leisure, he said, I promise you something beautiful. I said, I'm sure it will be beautiful, but it will be a third of the size. This is a totally unnecessary demolition.
And it's also unnecessary because we live in a city with a record number of billionaires.
Right.
Right now, de Blasio has a large surplus in his budget, yet he's cutting funding to libraries, and that plays right into what they want. This is about selling real estate. And
right.
It was from the beginning. So, and they say, at the beginning, they said they were only going to be selling this library. And then we found out that that wasn't true. Then we found out it was also Pacific. And then we found out it was also Sunset Park. And then we find out it was also Red Hook. They already gave away the children's room, a beautiful children's room in the Williamsburg Library, to a private group called Spaceworks that was created by Bloomberg without any public input. So there's this sense, there's this mentality, a consciousness of arrogance. We can do whatever we want
to.
We can sell these off.
What do they say they're doing?
It's not being done for the best interests of the public.
Right.
And what they have done to Brooklyn Heights and to Sunset Park and to Red Hook is to say, if you want air conditioning back, you have to sell your library. That is extortion.
What do they say that they're doing with these other libraries? I mean,
they're the same thing. They're trying to force the Sunset Park community
and to build
another luxury tower.
Yeah,
every library site.
They're actively doing it with Sunset Park. They're actively trying to push this on the Red Hook community, who has voted against it and pushed against it in their community board meetings. And they've told the community at the community board meetings that they will not get air conditioning unless they agree to sell the community-owned library, own the publicly-owned library. Do you see what's going on here?
Oh, yeah.
And every time, of course, they want to sell a library, they say it's an air conditioning problem. And they give the same cost, no matter what the size of the library, they give the same cost for the air conditioning. It's amazing what they can fabricate.
And they changed the price of fixing the air conditioner of this library 4 times in 1 year. They told the DC 37 librarians it was going to cost $350,000. They raised it to $750,000, which is the common number that they use for how much it costs to fix an air conditioner. Then they raised it to 3.5. They increased the price of fixing the air conditioner for this library. Anytime we mention at the community advisory meeting that we wanted to help fundraise to fix the air conditioner, we were shot down. Steve Levin, who offered some money, was shot down.
Oh, yeah.
They refused to accept money to help fix the air conditioner.
Oh, you know what?
And now they use that as a reason to sell a library, that it has a broken air conditioner. And they are saying that about Sunset Park and Red Hook. They also have broken air conditioners, and they say to the community, you will not get air conditioning unless you agree to sell your library. That is extortion.
That's right.
And that is against the law.
Thank you.
And stealing public treasures. It's just stealing public treasures, right? In the 1970s, when there was a real fiscal crisis in this city, the librarians and the library staff fought to not sell or shrink any library. We have the opposite situation now. We have a growing city, a city that is wealthier than ever before, with a record number of billionaires, a budget surplus, and we are saying that we can't afford our libraries, that we have to sell them and shrink them, and we have a growing population. So it's the exact opposite of what happened in the 1970s. The library administration itself is fighting so hard to shrink and sell off libraries. They're spending thousands of dollars on PR people, on lobbyists, on consultants, on fake charades and shreds to sell libraries, to convince the public that they want to sell their libraries. So the stewards of our public treasures, instead of protecting, nurturing, and growing their public treasures, are shrinking, underfunding, and exploiting these assets. And that is morally wrong. It's reprehensible.
It
strikes at the core of what it means to be human, to be connected, to care for people who are less fortunate than us.
Maybe it's the billionaires that need to shrink a little.
Yeah. Yes.
Thank you.
Okay.